Yesterday, Nancy Pelosi, Speaker of the House of Representatives, told reporters that she does absolutely not support in any way banning stock ownership or stock trading for members of Congress. She told those people it's a free market economy and they're allowed to participate in the free market economy. So Nancy Pelosi is effectively, you know, depending on your interpretation of it, really, I guess, defending the insider trading that is becoming rampant in the halls of Congress with both Republicans and Democrats. Okay, this is not a one party kind of thing. Both parties are doing it. Both parties' staffers are doing it. I had a video coming up about that over the weekend. Make sure you check it out. But anyway, they're doing this. The left is, the right is, the lawmakers are, the staffers are. And as Nancy Pelosi was out there defending these individuals trading stocks and getting rich off of their own legislation, effectively, a new report came out from Business Insider that says 75 lawmakers bought and sold stock in companies that make COVID-19 vaccines, treatments, and tests over the last 2 years. So as Nancy Pelosi is saying, hey, we're allowed to do this. It's okay. Everything's great and wonderful. Business Insider has this report saying, hi, they're profiting off the pandemic. They're the ones who are passing the laws and, you know, getting the tests out to people and providing the COVID money to cities and states so they can give people vaccines. And they're actually profiting off these same things that Nancy Pelosi is up there right now, literally defending. 49 lawmakers this year alone have been caught violating the Stock Act. Trading stocks, not disclosing it. Trading stocks based on legislation that they have pending in front of them. 49 lawmakers just this year have been caught violating that act. And none of them have faced any penalty at all. There is no consequence for this. There is nothing. Congress cannot own stock. I know they can. Congress should not own stock. I'm not even saying they shouldn't trade it. I'm saying they shouldn't own it at all. And I've been saying that for months. And when I first started saying that, it was a bit of a controversial take, right? Oh my God, Farron says nobody can own stocks in Congress. Yeah, now that's actually the talking point. Everybody has gotten on board with that because at the time people said, well, they shouldn't be able to trade stocks. Nope, everybody's come around now. These individuals should not be allowed to own stocks. Serving in Congress is a public service. And if that's not enough for you, then you need to go find another job. If you want to trade stocks all day long, there's a whole industry of that up north. You can go participate in that and do that as your full-time job, make a shit ton of money and do whatever the hell you want, except make laws. You want to make laws? You leave all that behind. You give it up. And you say, I am going to be a public servant and I'm going to do the job that I was hired to do and I'm not going to try to get rich on the side. Those are your options. You can't have it both ways, Nancy. You got to pick one or the other. You've got enough money that you'll be just fine if we ban stock ownership from members of Congress. Yeah, what? Well over $100 million, I think it is, in the bank. You're good. So are most of these other lawmakers. The poorer ones actually don't even own stock. But as long as the ownership continues, as long as the trades are allowed to happen, and as long as the Stock Act is not enforced on anyone, we're going to continue to see insider trading. We're going to continue to see these lawmakers profiting every step of the way. And with leadership like Pelosi, nothing will ever be done about it.